Okay, hello dear friends. Good morning. It's a beautiful morning outside. And here I am at Utah Contemporary Art Museum. And try something new and different. And modern art is very much about the new new vibe of the city, or the new energy, the coming thing of the city. So here is an installation art, and there are something quite interesting. Everything is interesting because it is interesting. Once you get into the artist mindset, you can understand. But if you are not, it may be quite hard to understand. So I will show you something that bring me to think. And I think this is an installation art. That is it. More than that, you usually cannot explain or do not need to explain. And there is no way you can explain. Here are some modern paintings. Understand it or not, they are modern paintings. This looks like a bumblebee. Geometric shapes. That's quite interesting. This looks like a bookshelf. This one. This looks like a painting. Painted with paint, with tapes. This looks like a geometric paper cut. Cut shaped paper. Ooh, that's a good one. That is a very good one. The study of color and shade. This is also very interesting. By pixels that shows the layer and depth. It's like a water depth. It's like a mountain peak, whichever way you think about it. It is definitely showing the depths of something. That is just the simple shape, but has such a powerful geometric or 3D feel. The color is very well studied. This is also very well meticulously designed. Each line has a certain length, and it's always the same length, same width, same density of color. Very interesting. How can one keep such consistency of color? It is great. Oh, that's some careful dot drop. Teeny tiny little drawings. I very much like this kind of drawing because it takes effort, it takes time, and it's very meditative, very interesting. You can see the emotion, you can see the shift of mind, the patience. And the artist started by doing some regulated shape and then get tired or get something new, change color, change shape. Why not keep on changing shape? Why not going back to my shape? Oh, I'm tired, I will do some big stroke and finish this work. Okay, let's go back to our original hard working. So this is very much, although it's not very, very, very significantly thought pondering, but it does show the art or creative process. I like it. It's very random. When you put your time and interest, put your heart into appreciating and into trying to understand it, it is very interesting to see another person's heart, right? Another person's idea and heart, and there is something that is explainable, or that is deeper, that you can understand, or you can use your way to ponder, to illustrate, and to think, to develop your thought. And a lot of time we do not understand other people. It's because we didn't put the time and energy into understanding other people. And this is why I choose to come to Utah, to Salt Lake City. Actually, the conference, there are three conferences, one in Boston. I wanted to go to Boston all the time, but I didn't get approval. I got, and there are Nashville and Utah, Salt Lake City. For some reason, school decided that they'd send me to Salt Lake City. And I always, always, always wanted, not always, I think only these couple of years, I started very, very much want to come to these places, come to Salt Lake City, come to Tennessee, come to Idaho, the place that is very different from where I live, from California, from other part of the country, other part of the world. Each place is different, and I want to see why people think differently, politically or culturally, think differently. And are we really different people? Can we talk to each other or cannot we? So I just want to come here to see how the people here, why people, what is the life here, and I want to understand a little bit more. And this trip proved to be the most eye-opening. I have a lot of time. I have 4 days of myself, and I lived in Airbnb, and I can go to good coffee shop, I can go to good shopping mall, or I can go to library. everything depending on myself. It's my own decision. So I go to places and I stay late in the coffee shop, just pondering and thinking about people who do not have a place to live. I met a very talented artist, homeless artist, and I have done a video. And I was just thinking about people who is unfortunate. Maybe they have tripped one time in their life or tripped many times in their lives and just stuck in the material condition. And it brings me more understanding of the people who live a different life, people who live a harsh life, and also people who live a comfortable life. Here, a lot of people, because of their religion, they live in with family, dress up well, and you start to understand more and think more and learn more and experience more. I am so happy, and I met the biggest meetup. We have 11 people showed up. Oh my gosh, it's unbelievable. People are so lovely. And I know everyone is different, so different, but we enjoyed so profoundly. Oh, what a pity. I have talked half an hour about this painting, only to realize I didn't press the record button. Okay, this is the second time I do this. And not talking about any political affiliation or cultural background. We just talk about the artistic expression of this painting. And I am attracted to this painting because it's colorful, it's very vibrant and very bright. Even with the black background, it's so bright. And on the other hand, when we see it, when we really put our attention into it, it's actually this background, this black background, bring the painting more to life. How does it work? So this painting is completely done in a piece of white, a black paper. It's black paper, not painted, or maybe painted. Anyway, it's a black background. To make a black background to show off, you have to use very strong color. And now there are paint markers or paints that can show off. But what I think, what I can learn, aspire from this painting is that I will do different background. You can see here are the backgrounds, different layers. There are darker ones. And these darker ones bring the depths of this painting. If everyone is bright and shiny, you lose the sense of depth and layer. So put several, 1, 2, 3, 4, however many different gradients of dark color, a little bit lighter, more lighter, 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 very light, very bright. And yeah, so different layer of color to make the bunch of flower sticks show off. And the layer of sticks, you can put a lot of sticks without doing very much of the paint. You can do some flowers. You can see here are some flowers, but mostly it's bringing the thickness of this flower bunch, and then start to do the bright. And for the bright ones, you can use paint or you can use cut paper, because paper is definitely opaque, and you can cut some paper and then stick to it. I think that might be also a good idea. And then do the final layer of painting. Make sense? So from this painting, what I have learned, first layering. Make different layer, different depths. Second, use paper cut. Use a variety of media and technique, and bring this painting more lively. So it's not only hand painted, but also paper cut and different technique, different method brings a lot of liveliness to this painting. Don't you agree? Okay, I hope this one is recorded, and it is. Thank you very, very much. So this is the museum, and thank you very, very much. I love you. I really do. Do, 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 do. Bye bye.